How many elements of order 2 are in Z8, the external direct product of Z2 with Z4, and the external direct product of Z2 with itself, having Z2 here show up 3 times? You could try to figure out in each case what the elements of order 2 are. Maybe you did that. Let's go ahead and do it that way. In Z8, there's only one element of order 2, 4. 4 is the unique element of order 2, right? 4 plus 4 is 0 mod 8. That's the only element of order 2. In fact, if you think about the fundamental theorem of cyclic groups, Z8 is a cyclic group. There's got to be a unique subgroup of order 2. And any group of order 2 has just one generator. There's got to be a unique element of order 2. It's 4. This is the unique element of order 2 in Z8. So Z8 has one element of order 2. In the external direct product of Z2 with Z4, do a little bit of experimentation. You're looking for elements of order 2. Here's one of them, right? 1, 0 added to itself. 1, 0 plus 1, 0 would be 2, 0. But 2 mod 2 is 0. You get back to 0, 0, the identity. Another element would be 0, 2. Add this to itself, you get 0, 4. But 4 mod 4 is 0. Get back to the identity. Could we combine these? Do you think 1, 2 has order 2? Yes, it does. 1, 2 added to itself gives you 2, 4. Mod the first component by 2. 2 mod 2 is 0. Mod the second component by 4. 4 mod 4 is 0. Anything else? I don't think so. I think that's it. You could try. How many elements are in here total? There's 8. We've listed 3 of them. There's 0, 0 as well. I'm pretty sure that all the other elements don't have order 2. You're nodding your head. Yes. Okay. These are elements of order 2 in Z8. Excuse me. The external direct product of Z2 with Z4. So Z2, external direct product of Z4, has 3 elements of order 2. In the external direct product of Z2 with itself having 3 factors, I hope you fairly quickly were able to see that every non-identity element has order 2. Right? The only elements you can write are ones with zeros and ones. 1, 0. Oops, but you need 3 components. 1, 0, 0. 0, 1, 0. 0, 0, 1. 1, 1, 0. 1, 0, 1. 0, 1, 1. And 1, 1, 1 are the 7 elements of this 8-element group, 2 times 2 times 2, that have order 2. So the elements of order 2 in this external direct product. So that external direct product has 7 elements of order 2. You can also think about all this with the LCM property. I overheard some of you doing that. In general, the order of an element of an arbitrary external direct product. This is an element of the external direct product of capital G1 with capital G2 with capital G3, etc., with capital Gn, where these are all finite groups. Is equal to the LCM, least common multiple, of the orders of the individual components. We don't need to think about this with Z8, but you can think about it with these other two examples because they're external direct products. So for the external direct product of Z2 with Z4, I like making tables like this. I've got an arbitrary element, A comma B, in that external direct product. So A is either 0 or 1, B is either 0 or 1 or 2 or 3. What are the possible orders of A? What are the possible orders of B? What's their LCM? And maybe I could use that to figure out the number of elements. In making a table like this, I'm actually going to figure out maybe the number of elements, for example, of order 4 as well, and order 1. A can be 0 or 1. 0 has order 1, 1 has order 2 in Z2. So the order of A can be either 1 or 2. B is in Z4, it can be 0, 1, 2, or 3. 0 has order 1. 2 in Z4 has order 2. 2 plus 2 is 0. Not 4. 1 and 3 have order 4. Their generators are Z4. So the possibilities for the order of B are 1, 2, and 4. Consider all possible combinations of those things. 1 and 1. 1 and 2. 1 and 4. 2 and 1. 2 and 2, 2 and 4 are the different possibilities. In each row, figure out the LCM. The LCM of 1 and 1 is 1. The LCM of 1 and 2 is 2. LCM of 1 and 4 is 4. LCM of 2 and 1 is 2. LCM of 2 and 2 is 2. LCM of 2 and 4 is 4. In other words, this column is giving me the corresponding orders of the element of A comma B based on this fact up here. And now in this final column, I try to count the number of elements in that have these possibilities. In the first row, the order of A is 1, the order of B is 1. That corresponds to 0, 0 in here, right? 0, 0 is the identity. Yeah, the order of the identity is 1. That's the only element of order 1. There's only one of them. If you want, you could write it as 1 times 1 equals 1 because there's one possibility for A and one possibility for B. Go to the next row. There's one possibility for A. A is, in fact, it's got to be 0 if it's got order 1. There's also only one possibility for B. B has order 2 in Z4, means B has to be the number 2. Nothing else, not 0, not 1, not 3. There's one possibility for each case. So there's one element that fits this pattern. Next row, once again, A has order 1. It's got to be the number 0 in Z2. B has order 4. There's two possibilities for B to have order 4 in Z4. It could be 1 or it could be 3. There's 1 times 2, two possibilities. Keep going. For each of these possible orders of A, 2, 2, and 2, there's only one thing A can be in Z2. It's got to be the number 1. For these two things for B, the order of B, they lead to one possibility for what B could be. And this one, once again, leads to 2. So here you have 1 times 1, 1 times 1, and 1 times 2 again. The total of the numbers in this column, 8, has to match the order of the group. How many elements based on this analysis? have order 2 in here. They come from those three rows. Corresponding number of elements is 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 3. Three elements of order 2. Just like we listed out before and saw there were three elements of order 2 here, we can use the LCM analysis. But the LCM analysis does more for us. It also, for example, shows us how many elements there are of order 4. They come from these two rows. 2 plus 2, 4. There are going to be 4 elements of order 4.